end of 2021, I had a small problem on my right foot. I had to race for a few months, actually almost 2.5 months. You know, with KTM, we changed the bike.
The new bike was already on a high note coming from R&D. We had some good input there from like our perspective, from motorsport perspective. Once Tom tested first time, there was positive feedback.
So it's a total different bike from the frame to the engine. We had to work the suspension, also work a lot on the new engine.
Of course, having a new bike is always a bit of a challenge because it comes to those little details and the fine tuning and stuff like that. It took us a bit of time to get to know the bike, to get to understand how it works and stuff like that. But yeah, we are actually pretty happy with where we are at the moment.
There's still some small things to come. Yeah, what we see so far, it's a pretty good bike, and I think we are ready for the first GP.
So it was pretty a tough and short winter, actually. So I didn't came to the first round, let's say, fully prepared and ready to start the season. I needed more time, actually.
We started the season really behind the eight ball.
Yeah, I really wanted to win, you know, like I wanted to win, and yeah, I had a small crash the last lap. Second of all, for the first GP, we start, let's say, good the season, so yeah, now we go to next weekend, Montauban. You know, I'm pretty young still, I never start on the GP on the dirt, so I always start on the gates.
We get as much of the mud off as possible. So we use a lot of tape underneath the mud guards, underneath the front mud guard, underneath the skid plate, to try and keep that bike as light as possible and as clean as possible for the mesh start.
Before the first moto, I practice one start to just have the feeling with the bike and with the clutch.
Well, you know, back in the day, so we raced 45 minutes. Now it's only 35. Start becomes really important. It's actually 35 minutes. It's pretty much one long sprint from the beginning to the end.
The most important thing that is the first, I think, the suspension is quite important to have a good base on the bike, and of course the engine. Like I said before, the 250 engine needs a lot of power. So that's the 2 points we look for. Suspension, I would say, first, and then engine.
It's unreal what the modern bikes, what those forks and suspension, what they can, the impact they can take, and how comfortable they can make a rider feel. These bikes, every day, I'm impressed by how much impact those modern bikes can take, and that's making them faster, and maybe in some way, yeah. Makes the risk also a bit higher.
Vialle has gone big, running towards his bike. Oh, that was a strange crash. If we have a behind view of that, I would like to see what happened.
For sure, thought that I think that was season done. Seeing the violence that he flew through the air, and yeah, it was huge.
The GP in Sardinia was an important one.
Fight that effort on the final turn. Absolutely nothing in it. The flag goes out, and it is by 0.3 seconds. Tom Vialle, who wins race two, wins the Sardinian Grand Prix.
We saw, I think, the real Tom Vialle at his best level this year so far.
In France, I think for every French rider, it's so special. I mean, the public is amazing there, and I win both GP this year, and I couldn't do better, you know, like my last one, let's say, in France was even nicer, and I could win for the fun, and was so nice.
Probably the only mechanical sport where fans can come that close to the stars, let's say, and that creates a really, really specific atmosphere, which you don't find in the other disciplines, so and we're proud of it.
Vialle wins here in France. and a crucial one as well, because he now reduces the gap from 15 to 2 points as we head into the final round.
Tom's also a smart guy. He doesn't panic too often. He believes in himself. And I think, yeah, that's which brought us still in the hunt of the championship today.
Final round this weekend, the Vichy MXGP of Turkey. We are at Afyon in the west of the country. Two riders, 2 points, two races.
Yeah, we are in Turkey, last GP of the race. It's going to be a nail biter, only 2 points difference.
Yeah, last ever race in Europe. It's a little bit of emotion, you know. Before leaving to the US, for sure I want to make it good for the last one.
To bring it back within 2 points instead of 11, you know, it's huge.
From our side, our strategy is actually simple. We have it in our own hands now. If Tom wins two motos, we don't need to calculate. Then he's going to be the world champion.
There's only one thing to do now. That's, yeah. First in time qualifying, first in the qualification race. I'm sure it gives Tom a lot of confidence heading into tomorrow. And yeah, it's just overall a good feeling. Had a good feeling with the bike and the track, so overall, focus is fully on tomorrow.
Shot. But what a finale we had here at Afyon. Tom Vialle, a two-time FIM MX2 Motocross World Champion. But to win this one, coming from behind like he did the last few rounds. Congratulations, Tom Vialle, Red Bull KTM Factory Racing.
Can't even put it into words, mate. Such a crazy day. That last moto was insane. You know, after the year we had, all the trials and all the stuff behind the scenes and losing Rene last year. Yeah, it's a lot, eh?
Every year down to the last moto, this is getting too intense, you know? I mean, it's really good racing and nice to watch, but well-deserved. Yeah, finally it's over.
I said to Tom, be very strong in the head, because at the end, you know, it's a kind of mental game, you know. It was the same last year with Jeffy.
Yeah, I'm actually lost for words. I think Alfred Hitchcock could have never written such a scenario like what we experienced today. And I also, I don't want to experience it anymore in my life, because I think this for sure cost me 5 years of my life. And with the whole team, yeah, we're so grateful. And we had the tragic loss of Rene in the winter. And like in that last round, we all feel like, we could all feel Rene's support, and I think he has helped us just to take that last step.
It's a gold plate, and it belongs to Tom Vialle, the 2022 FIM MX2 Motocross World Champion.